Posting to Instagram from the desktop has long been a dream for many marketers and users. And while there have been plenty of third-party tools out there as workarounds, we haven't had the option to post natively to Instagram via the desktop until recently, thanks to the new Facebook Creator Studio, which allows us to post and schedule directly to Instagram. I'm gonna walk you through everything you need to know to access the Creator Studio and post to Instagram. Stick around. Thanks to the Facebook Creator Studio, Instagram users have the option to post natively from the desktop to Instagram. Let's figure out how. And stick around to the end of the video where I'm gonna show you how to add multiple Instagram accounts so you can manage all of your business accounts. So to access the Facebook Creator Studio, you're gonna wanna go to facebook.com/creatorstudio and then go ahead and click the login button if you're not already logged in via either your Facebook or your Instagram account. So once you've logged in to the Creator Studio, it's going to default to your Facebook profile. There up at the very top, there's the Facebook tab and the Instagram tab. Just click on the Instagram tab and it'll take you right to your Instagram content library with all of your posts. So now that you're into the Creator Studio and you're ready to create some content, what can you post? You can create regular feed posts. You can do photos, videos, and carousels even. Or you can do IGTV videos, but you cannot do stories using the Creator Studio. So now that you're ready to create a post, you're gonna slide on over to the left side of the screen where you see the big blue Create Post button, and you're gonna click on that. We know Instagram and Facebook love to change things, so it may look slightly different when you see this screen. So when you click on the Create Post button, you're gonna get two options. One is gonna be for Instagram feed, one is for IGTV. In this case, we're gonna do a feed post, so go ahead and click on Instagram feed. Now you're gonna see over on the right-hand side, a screen's gonna pop up for you to choose which Instagram account that you wanna post content to. In this case, if you only have one account open, you're only gonna have one to choose from. So you're gonna click that and that'll move to the next screen. However, stick around to the end because if you have multiple accounts, I'm gonna show you how to add all those extra accounts for when you log in. So once you're in the actual post creation screen, you'll see it's very easy to use. It's very clearly laid out. You have your place to place your caption, you have the add location field, and then you have the upload content field. You even have the option to check that little box and share automatically to Facebook. You'll notice that with no content in here, the publish button is grayed out. That will not turn blue and you will not be able to click on it until you have uploaded a piece of visual content, whether that's a photo, video, or multiple components for a carousel. When you click on add content, you're gonna get the option to upload from your computer or from your Facebook page. In this case, I'm actually gonna go ahead and select from my Facebook page and I'm gonna choose this one here and then go ahead and continue with selected posts. If I wanted to make this a carousel, I could actually choose multiple images and those would go in as the carousel. In this case, I'm gonna do just one for a single post. Now that I have the visual content, I can go ahead and write in my post caption. The fun thing that I actually like about the Creator Studio is you can see right here, it actually shows you how many characters you have remaining as you type out your captions. So captions are limited to 2,200 characters, and as you type, this ticker actually keeps track. Likewise, if you at mention somebody, so in this case, if I at mentioned social media examiner, and they pop up and I select them, now I have 29 mentions left. And as you use hashtags in your content, now you can see how many hashtags are still available for me to use so you won't go over your limit. Now here's a caveat that maybe this will change in the future, but for right now, the way the Creator Studio is set up, you can only put your hashtags in the caption. If you're typically somebody who likes to put your hashtags in a first comment, you would either have to do that manually after this post has gone live, or there are some third-party tools that allow you to do a first comment post with your content, but the Creator Studio does not offer that functionality. If I wanted to add a location, I would go ahead and start typing that in here so I can pick a city, I can pick a very specific location, and now my post is ready to upload. Go ahead and go down here to publish. You can simply click the publish button and it's gonna go live right away on your Instagram account. If you go ahead and click on schedule, you're going to get the option to choose the calendar, date, and time. And when you go ahead and click schedule, it's actually going to go ahead and pop up in your content library now, showing that that is a scheduled post for a future date. Now, the caveat to using the scheduling tool with the Facebook Creator Studio is that you can't actually edit or change the scheduled post time of anything that's in your content library. So if it's a post that's already gone live, you can't edit the content. If it's a post you have scheduled, you can't edit the content. Meaning if you have a spelling mistake or you wanted to add something or delete something, you can't do it from the Creator Studio. You would actually have to delete the post altogether and then recreate it within the Creator Studio and then reschedule it to go back out. If it's a live post, you can just head over to your Instagram profile and you can edit directly from within Instagram. Now, of course, that's how this currently works, and we never know when Instagram and Facebook will make changes. So try to edit before you just jump over and edit it on Instagram. Try to edit it here within the Creator Studio. Hopefully they update that functionality at some point in the future. One of the things to remember when you're uploading video is that video files have to be between 3 seconds and 60 seconds in duration. If it's shorter or longer than that, you actually won't have the option to upload it. You also want to make sure that it's either in a 4:5 or 16:9 ratio that fits within the normal Instagram parameters. The content you upload is exactly how it's gonna go out on Instagram. There's no editing functionality like filters or any of those sorts of things we're used to on Instagram. So you wanna pre-edit all of your content in advance to make sure that it's ready to go the moment you get it into the Creator Studio. In order to upload an IGTV video, you're gonna click on the Create Post and choose IGTV from the dropdown. Then you're gonna choose the Instagram account that you wanna post to, and now you're in the IGTV video content creation screen. For the file upload options for IGTV videos, you can upload from a file on your computer or again from your Facebook page. File restrictions for IGTV videos are a minimum of 15 seconds and up to 60 minutes if you're uploading from the desktop. You're gonna wanna give your IGTV video a good title that's descriptive to what is coming up in that video, and then you're gonna wanna fill in your description for that video as well. Here's where you want to give more insights and information into what they're getting out of this video. This is where you can also include your call to action and put a clickable link. All users have the ability to put a clickable link in an IGTV video description. You also get to use hashtags here to show up in more search results, and you can do up to 30 hashtags in your description. If you want more information on how to use hashtags for IGTV videos, make sure you check out our video on that exact topic here on this same channel. As with uploading IGTV from a mobile device, you have the option to upload a custom thumbnail for that video. So you want to create that thumbnail in advance, have that ready to go in your file folder, and you can upload that directly in here so you have a custom thumbnail on your videos. So one of the tricks to getting more views on your IGTV videos is to share a preview of the video to your Instagram feed. This way it actually shows up to all of your followers as a 1-minute preview. To share your preview to the feed, you're going to click this box right here, and at that point you will get the preview for any videos over 60 seconds in length. When your video content is uploaded and ready to go, you can click publish to publish immediately, or you can schedule by clicking the down arrow and selecting the schedule option, choosing the date and time that you want that video to go live. Now, when you do upload videos that are longer in length, sometimes it won't show up immediately in the Creator Studio because it takes a little while to process and get in there. So give it a few minutes and then it'll be ready for you to view. So now that you know how to schedule and post to both IGTV and Instagram, it's bonus time. I'm gonna show you how to add multiple Instagram accounts so that you can use all of your different accounts to create content using the Creator Studio. You're gonna click on the Instagram accounts option from the left-hand menu. When you do that, you'll see any of the accounts you currently have logged in, and in the top right corner, you'll see the Add Instagram Account button. Click on that and follow the prompts to go through and add any additional accounts you have access to. So in this case, click Switch Accounts and log in with your new account. So in order to add an Instagram account to the existing list. It has to be an Instagram account that you have admin access to as the Facebook page. Now you're already logged in as your existing Facebook page, which is a 1-to-1 ratio to an Instagram account. So to add additional Instagram accounts, your Facebook page that you're logged in as in the Creator Studio has to have page access to the additional Facebook pages that have the other Instagram accounts you want to add. Once you've added the extra Instagram accounts, you can easily toggle back and forth between those account options to go ahead and schedule any of your content or add content as needed to each individual account. Knowing how to use the Creator Studio to create content for Instagram is wonderful, but having high quality content that works for you and your audience is also incredibly important. Fortunately for you, we've created a video on Instagram insights so that you will know exactly what content performs well for your audience and how to create more of it. Check out the video on your screen now. I'll see you over there.